Okay, welcome to another review and unboxing. Really excited today because we're opening up the original Predator from Hot Toys, arguably one of the best Predators they've made. Next to PT Elder, maybe Asia Ancient, Scar and some others, but this one here is a great one. It came out in Q2 2009, around 4 years after the AVP series, Celtic. box is a great box. I mean, it's slightly bigger than the Billy Soul and Dutch. It's got this outer skin, which is the camouflage. Just take off. So that looks pretty cool. Very unique. Inside the box, we've got a list of the accessories there, and the actual Predator himself looks pretty upset, actually. Great line. The box, I'm going to give it a 5 out of 5 just because it's very, very unique and the first to come out with that sort of sleeve. The box. Okay, so in terms of accessories, got them all out now. We've got an extra pair of hands, an extra hand there for the left hand, an extra pair of mandibles for when he's closed, the helmet with the LEDs. Medical kit, I think we've got Hawkins there with the spine. A fantastic custom display. That's just awesome. The stand instructions and a couple of batteries there for the LEDs. In terms of accessories, I want to give it a 4 out of 5. No, actually a 5 out of 5, I think, because there's some that are on the Predator himself. He's got his plasma cannon on there, a whole range of souvenirs of skeletons and things around his neck, which I'll show you in a second. So definitely a 5 out of 5. Yeah, that head, that mask there is just awesome. But yeah, let's put him together. Okay, so there he is, and he looks fantastic. He's with a custom background I've been building. But he looks great. I mean, in terms of reference material, it's definitely a 5 out of 5, as is the likeness. The dreads are just fantastic, straight out of the box. Much better than Berserkers, and better than the AVP series as well. And I'll put some of those things up later so we can just compare them. But in terms of head sculpt, was done by Pan Mac. I'd actually heard of him recently, so I'm not sure what he's been doing, but he did a fantastic job on there. It is actually a little bit heavy, like the Berserker figure. The articulation is pretty cool. You can actually achieve a lot of things, and I'll do some of those poses in a second. In terms of what he's got on him, I've put him in this pose because this is the end fight pose, sort of. He's got his detonation device, the medical kit, which is great because it unfolds and opens up twice, so it opens up there, and then the bottom part comes out. And everyone needs one of these, so we should get one. The skeletons, the base, everything's just awesome. The mandibles, the head sculpt. Yeah, in terms of articulation, again, I'm gonna give it a 5 out of 5 again. In terms of value for this one, it's probably a 5 in terms of value. If you can get it for around 500, there's still a few up there about 750 on eBay at the moment. But anything under 500, I think, is good value for this type of figure. It did come out about 2 years ago. Well, yeah, 2 years ago. So it's definitely increased in value. Overall, it's a 29 out of 30 for me. Arguably one of the best Predator figures produced by Hot Toys. Definitely worth getting if you can get it, and yeah, I'll try a few different poses now and see how he looks. But again, just in that position there, as you can see there, you know, he looks like he's definitely out of the film. It would be great going forward if Hot Toys could do a camouflage version, you know, 1/6 scale, or like when he's coming out of the water and the electricity is sort of messing with his camouflage. That would be great. Yeah, he's one ugly motherfucker, pardon the language there. But he did take Arnie's team down. Killed Billy Blaine, Hawkins, Dylan, geez, Poncho, everyone. So, yes. Arnie should have chopped off his head and then held it for his collection, but anyway. All right, we'll go to a few poses now and compare him to the some of the other figures. So there they are together. So in terms of who's the better hunter, you have to say Arnie, because he did win in the end. He did set a trap, he lured him in, which is not an easy thing to do, and he executed his plan. Now, having said that, I mean, not everything went to plan, as you can see at the end of the film, but he did come on top, and he did similar to what Royce did to Berserker. So here they are together. I would love Hot Toys to do a tied-up version of this Predator for the new Predators film. With Berserk and Falcona. That'll be a great addition to the display, particularly if it was like a diorama. yeah, thanks for watching another review. I'm just gonna put Berserker and some of the Celtic Predators up now. So we just have a look. So we'll just move Arnie to the side. So Berserker's a little bit taller. Well, it's probably the same height. I've got this guy bent a bit. They're not happy people, these Predators. I'm not sure what they do for their leisure time in terms of time off. but you can see there, the comparison. Both head sculpts are great. But again, this is the original, so that's why it's the best. I've got a Celtic here, which I think is slightly taller. So I'll move Berserker back. Yeah, so Celtic's slightly taller, which is interesting because he's probably younger because he goes to that planet to train, so interesting that he's taller than all of them. But there's the three of them. I'll put some poses up the front of the video in terms of display there. But yeah, looking great. Alright, thanks for watching and stay tuned for more reviews. I've got a few more boxes to open. So we'll go from there. Thanks again and yeah, keep collecting. Cheers.